approve of me. Why don't you come on over that way?
Can I say something?
Yeah.
You're really good.
Thank you.
What's your name?
I'm Meve.
Hi, Meve. My name's Howie. Want to be on Canada's Got Talent? Yeah? What are you thinking?
This is crazy. Oh my gosh.
Want to come in and see how it goes?
Yeah, I do. Hi.
Hi. What's your name?
I'm Meve.
I know.
Yeah. My name's Meve. I'm from here, from Niagara Falls.
No, so. Legitimately. Okay, so I know, I swear to you people, this is absolutely true. I went outside and I heard you sing.
Yeah.
That's absolutely true, right?
Yeah, 100%.
And you weren't expecting to be on Canada's Got Talent, right?
I can't believe I'm here right now. Like,
I swear to you.
What did you think you were doing today?
I was gonna go home and eat some pizza, but like I'm here now instead, so.
Do you have even a track to sing to?
I don't, no. I didn't really have time for that, but we're gonna do it a cappella. It's okay, it's fine.
I wish you the best of luck.
Thank you.
Sometimes surprises can turn into dreams.
Yeah, absolutely.
I hope that's what happens tonight. Best of luck.
Me too. Thank you.
Actually, real. I swear to you.
There is a house in New Orleans. They call the rising sun, and it's been the ruin of many a poor boy. But God, I know I'm one. Now your only thing a gambler needs is a suitcase and a truck. And the only time he's on is when he's on a drunk. Well, there is a house in New Orleans. They call the rising sun, and it's been the ruin of many a poor boy.
I'll tell you, I've performed on probably thousands at this point, thousands of stages, but I don't know if I've ever had the pressure of what just happened to you. Not everybody under that type of pressure with like no time to prepare can come up there and deliver the way that you did today. Thank you for sharing that gift with all of us today.
Thank you so much.
I don't say this often, but Howie, you did something great. You are proof that the universe has a plan. This is the beginning of something spectacular, and I think
absolutely
your life is going to change.
Thank
absolutely
you so much. Thank you.
I think talent is like a treasure, and sometimes it's buried, and sometimes you just got to find it and you unearth it. I think we just found a buried treasure. So let's start the voting, Cardi.
It's a yes, sir.
Trish?
Yes, from me.
Two yeses. I can't even wait to see what you do with preparation. Yes.
You got four yeses.
All right.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
That's good. That's good. You're just outside.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
That's amazing. That's amazing.
She was just outside. I hid behind the crowd, And I put like $5 in her thing. Wow.
She was just startled because she couldn't believe it's only $5 that you put in there.
Hi. What's your name, sir?
Robbie Hunt.
Can I ask how old you are?
26.
And how long have you been performing music?
Since I was a kid. I was standing in the middle of the street and I sing. And it's the every second thought, you know?
And where do you live, Robbie?
Everywhere.
What do you mean, everywhere?
My current status at the moment is I am homeless.
Ah, okay.
I've been homeless for about 6 years on and off. Two nights out of every fortnight, like, I'll stay somewhere, like a friend's house or something. But the rest of the time, yeah, just kicking out on the street. I sleep in doorways, alleyways, just trying to keep dry. As a child, I felt like I was a big burden on people. I grew up in a single mother family. She had three jobs that she used to work every week. You know, it took its toll on her. So I was put into care at 13 years old. I never really gelled with any of the families or any of the people that I got with. And so it was easier for me to just shut myself away and just put my brain into things I love to do. I have always sung. I don't think there's anything else in my life that I do with such, you know, such passion. This competition is obviously a big thing. It could add the element of security. It could change my life, yeah, definitely.
You've obviously had a difficult life. Has music helped you?
Yeah, and it showed me that I'm worth a little something.
Okay. What are you going to sing for us today?
Damien Rice, Coconut Skins.
Okay.
I hope he's going to be good, do you?
Robbie, good luck.
Now you can hold her hand and show her how you cry. Explain to her your weakness so she understands. Then roll over and die. You can break decisions before you crumble up inside. Spend your time asking everyone else's permission. Then run away and hide. You can sit on chimneys, yeah. Put some fire up your eyes. No need to know what you're doing or waiting for. But if anyone should ask, tell them I've been licking coconut skins. We've been hanging out. Tell them God just dropped by to forgive our sins and relieve us our doubts. Oh, now you can hold her wrist, but your basket has a hole. You can lie between her legs and go looking for, tell her you're searching for her soul, yeah. You can wait for ages, watch your compass turn to cold. But time is contagious, and everybody's getting old. Thank you.
Okay, Rita.
What do you feel like when you listen to music?
You know, when you listen to music and when you listen to that song of the time and the place where you remember that song and it creates the scene?
Yeah.
That's what it does.
I think you are more than capable of doing that for other people.
To Lisa.
Robbie, I am really glad that you came today. You look like someone that's been lost for a while, and I think you've lost your confidence in your skill, and I think you need to realise the potential you have and how good you are.
Yeah, Robbie, I think you're a very talented guy. But I don't think you've had a break in life. you know, and I think you absolutely deserve that.
Robbie, I think you've got lots of talent and absolutely zero confidence, and that's the only thing to work on from my perspective. Robbie, we're going to vote right now. Louis.
Robbie, I think you're talented. And I'm going to give you a chance, and I'm going to say yes.
Robbie, I am going to say yes.
Thank you, Teresa.
Robbie. I say yes.
Bobby, you've got four yeses. You know I'll be well done.
Congratulations. Go down there. I'm thrilled for you. Good job.
I feel like he's here ready to turn a new page.
If you give him time, give him space, and you give him some of your knowledge,
yeah,
I think you'll come back with a bang.
You're going to bring it when you come back.
We're going to have to, aren't we? We're going to have to.
Hello, you. How are you?
I am so nervous.
And me. I've been like that all day. You know why? Because they made us go in the ghost train. So I'm as nervous as you are right now, trust me. This is nothing. So, your name is Rebecca Grace?
Yeah.
And where are you from?
I'm from Raynham, Essex.
How old are you again?
20.
20. And what do you do for a living, Rebecca?
I work in McDonald's.
So, but this is not what you planned, so singing is your passion, yeah?
Yeah.
OK. And who are you here with today?
My mum, my dad, my sister and my partner.
Make as much noise as you want, by the way. I feel like we just opened the door to a library.
So when you were nervous before, what were your family saying to you at the time?
My dad was just like, you know, like, you can do this, but my dad's, like, one of the worst people to be around. I love him to pieces, but every time I look at him, I just start laughing.
Why?
I can always imagine...
I can hear him now. Is he here? I can literally hear him.
I can always imagine him, like, telling me a joke.
OK, but he has encouraged you, yeah?
Yeah, no.
OK. Let's do it.
Go on.
Oh, my God.
And all I remember is your back. Walking towards the airport, leaving a song in your past. I traveled 1,500 miles to see you. I begged you to want me, but you didn't want to. Peace by peace, you collected me up off the ground when you abandoned things, yeah. Piece by piece, he filled the holes that you burned in me at 6 years old. You know, he never walks away, he never asks for money, he takes care of things, he loves me. Piece by piece, he restores my faith that a man can be kind and a father could stay. Piece by piece, piece by piece, I fell far from the tree. I'll never leave her like you left me, and she'll never have to wonder her worth, because and a father should be great. Peace by peace. Peace by
Rebecca, that was the perfect song for your voice. And you sang it effortless, because it's a very emotional song.
Yeah. It's a huge song.
It's a huge, but you did it. So do you not realize how good you are? And how good you could be?
It's from listening to, like, recordings of myself, I'm always like, oh, because when I listen to it back, the more you listen to it, the more you're like, oh, I've done something wrong there.
You're your own biggest critic.
Yeah, so I'm like...
Well, you have an amazing voice.
Thank you.
Really have. You've got a recording voice.
Thank you.
What do you think, Sharon?
Yeah, you have a huge voice. And right now, you're like a rough diamond. You need smoothing out and just finding your confidence, standing your ground. Beautiful song choice.
Thank you.
Yeah, you're coming with some heat. It's pretty powerful, Miss Grace.
But I'm only human.
What was all the nerves about?
I really like you, Rebecca.
Thank
Do you know,
you.
For the first time, I don't know why, I've never listened to the lyrics like I just listened to it with you. I listened to every word and I understood what the song was because I think you're really sincere.
Thank you.
I do. And I get the lack of confidence thing, Rebecca, you know, but it's your thing to make happen or not.
Yeah.
Right? I'm going to remember you, Rebecca. Something about you I really like.
Thank you.
Right, Louis, yes or no?
Rebecca Grace, yes.
Sharon.
Oh, it's a yes from me, Rebecca.
Nicole.
Little Miss Grace, it's an absolute yes.
Guess what, Rebecca Grace? You know what's coming? Four yeses.
Sorry.
What up, Peter?
Come here. Come on, Team House, bring it in.
Oh, my God. I don't know what's your name.
Mary Bourne. My name is Mary, I'm 50 years old, and I work on the tills in Tesco's. I'm on one till all the time. And that's number 40. I always sing at the till. I'd be told to shut up by the staff. But what I really want to do is sing. I wanted to be a legend like Shirley Bassey or Tom Jones. Everybody at work is really supporting me. They tell me I have something very special that makes the hairs on the back of the neck stand up when I hit high notes. They really are excited for me and they're literally supporting me all the way.
Hello, everybody.
Hello.
Hello, Simon. I've been told by so many women to give you a big hello from Ireland. I had to get that in.
Thank you very much. Okay, what's your name?
It's Mary, Mary Bourne.
Mary, how old are you?
I'm 50, I was 50 last November.
Okay, Mary, what do you work at?
I work in Tesco's on a till.
How long have you been working there?
I'm 11 years there.
Or you want to be a singer?
I'd love to be a singer. It's only in the last 5 years I've got the courage back into me to go out and do it.
And are your family supportive?
My family are great supporters of, and my friends in the job as well, of being fantastic.
And what's your song?
My song is I Have Nothing by Tom Jones.
Big song.
Let's hope I do it justice.
Off you go.
I who have nothing. I who have no one, adore you and want you so, but I'm just a no one with nothing to give you but all. Restaurants, but I can only watch you eat. My nose pressed up against the window pane. I who have nothing. I who have no one. Just watch you go dancing by, wrapped in the arms of somebody else. When, darling, it's I who love you.
auditions and one of the most real auditions of the whole day, because you pick a big, big song and you hit every single note. Tesco could be in trouble.
Mary, that was my favourite audition of Dublin so far.
Thanks, Cheryl.
It was just full to the brim.
Thank you.
Power and emotion and passion. I thoroughly enjoyed it. I found myself getting goosebumps. It was fantastic.
Thank you very much.
Katie.
I think you're very brave. And I applaud your effort. And it's amazing how you said you had the courage to come back and do it. I don't know whatever stopped you.
Low self-esteem, darling.
Low self-esteem. Well, whatever we say, you know, don't let it affect you. I think that you brought something that's different.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Mary, I think it is quite important that what we say does affect you, because this is an audition. And I think you have the best voice out of everyone who's auditioned tonight.
You just don't know what that means to hear that
Mary,
from you.
And actually, more than that, I really like you.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
We're going to vote now, Mary.
Oh,
I'm going to kick it off. 1,000,000% yes.
Thank you, Lori.
Katie?
It's a yes for me.
Cheryl?
Big, big yes for me.
Simon?
2,500.
I can't believe Simon Cowell actually said I was one of the best.
He said you were the best voice.
Oh, did he? Oh, my God. This day has been the most important and happy and, for me, successful in my life. It's made me feel a better person today.
It's
going to make me cry. I know, I'm
Good evening. What's your name, sir?
My name is John Courtney.
Where are you from?
I live in a village called Mosley, which is near Manchester.
Oh, OK. Have you brought anyone with you?
I've got my wife and two boys, I hear.
Brilliant. How long have you played the piano?
Since I was about 5, I guess.
And is that how you make a living?
Yeah.
So is this the biggest venue you've performed in?
Yeah. The Palladium is like the Holy Grail to me. I used to watch the shows with my dad, and this is the home of variety.
Oh.
Overwhelming. It's amazing.
Oh, he's so happy.
Good luck, John.
Thank you. This is bonkers.
There was a man who had a dream that Simon Cowell and his team would watch him play piano and try to slay them on the stage of the Palladium. And in the time that one song took, David would write another book. Alicia would smile at him. Amanda would be kind to him. Simon's teeth would be blinding him if he was smiling. But nothing now could ever spoil the dream he dreamed like Susan Boyle.
I like this already.
Yes, John.
Let's see if we haven't been in it yet.
Fact is, he never thought he'd ever get to be in front of millions of people doing his thing on TV. 30 years of playing in piano bars and pubs, dodging glasses when they're thrown, being thrown out of clubs. When your children ask, Daddy, when you're coming home, this game is not the same when you're just Daddy on the phone. So he sits at the piano and he tries to get prepared, thinking he'll write it in third person so he doesn't feel as scared to sing about himself to a bunch of strangers in the dark. But then Britain has Got Talent, and he wants to make his mark. Paul Potts won the first year and said it was insane. The second year, George Sampson won, singing in the rain. Lost Voice Guys season 12, and last year Colin Thackeray. So why not me?
Why not you?
That's what he said. His youngest boy, one night in bed. Dad, why not you? Go and show them what you do. And even though you'll be a wreck, at least you'll meet Anton Deck. On stage, at this stage in his life, with an expensive mortgage and a pensive wife. His youngest son, Alfie, says, what's it all about? If he had any hair left, he'd pull it out. His teenage son said, His dad taught him to play piano, but he didn't live to see his son at the famous theatre performing on TV. If he didn't see it through, imagine how sad the look on the faces of both his lads, who always tell him, you're the greatest showman, Dad. And they'll see me on BGT. No more third person, just daddy. This is me.
To bits, I don't know why. I just saw a man who kind of made all his dreams come true.
It really was, yeah.
David.
It was just so winning, wasn't it? Yeah. I mean, my goodness me, it made the whole audience, and I'm sure everyone watching at home, just fall in love with him.
I love him.
He had everything, and at the end, he had us moved to tears. This show is perfect for you, and now I want to see you go as far as you can in this competition.
Wow.
Well done.
John, it was just a wonderful audition.
You're
somebody who's worked for years, needs a break. You'll get a huge reaction of this, I promise you. And we all want you to do well. So I would love to be the first to say yes.
You deserve it. You deserve it. Here's the other son. Here he comes.
What's your name?
This is Nora.
Nora.
Oh my God, I love her.
Nora, dare I ask how old you are?
What is she? She's asking me. 96.
Oh. How long have you been playing the piano?
Not me.
No, she's not.
Oh, you're not playing.
She does.
You're playing. Is this your daughter?
Yes, I'm her daughter.
Right. What's your name?
I'm Pam. But
Pam.
This is the act. I'm just accompanying. She's sung for people all her life. And so at 96, this is a treat. This stage, London Palladium audience.
Brilliant. Well, I can't wait.
Ready?
My darling.
Oh, I couldn't see.
Hello.
I couldn't see him.
That's okay. Hello.
Hello.
You are a very special lady because you're full of life, full of laughter, full of joy, and you've just entertained the nation at 96.
Once a showwoman, always a showwoman. I really enjoyed that whole performance. It was just completely charming. Congratulations, Nora.
Thank you very much.
It was a very special audition, Nora. You're a generation that, you know, this country is built on. So very well done and thank you.
Be happy again. Keep on smiling.
I didn't like you very much. I love you.
We're gonna take a boat.
Nora.
Yes.
Yes.
Exactly.
Yes, over here. Hello, darling. Hello, darling.
Oh, just here, you
darling.
Are.
Yes, I know. I keep moving around. Nora, it is my honor to give you your first yes.
Nora, it's my pleasure to give you your second yes.
Yes from me.
I think we've got about 4,000 yeses here, Nora.
Be happy again. Keep smiling. When you're smiling, baby, the whole world.
Thank you.
Smiles with you.
How's it going? Ari.
Oh, hello. What's your name?
My name is Aaron J.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good.
Where are you from?
I'm from Galway.
Galway.
But, yeah, Galway.
What do you do, darling?
I'm a songwriter slash rapper.
Oh. So do you write your own rhymes then?
Yes.
And are you writing about a significant other? Are you single?
I'm single, yeah.
Are you? Well, you won't be after tonight. Okay, well, are you going to rap for us tonight?
Yeah, I'm going to perform an original song. It's written by myself. It's called Show Pain.
I've been a songwriter for most of my life, I suppose. I only recently started to actually perform music. It'd be cool to see something completely different, you know, like a songwriter, not a rapper, like, that jumps around the stage, but someone who can... You can listen to my songs and they'd be like, right, there's a lot of power here, there's a lot of passion, and that's what I want to show people, that, like, it's not just all an image. Today, I will be performing my own original song called Show Pain. It is about depression and anxiety. It is written from my own experiences. Growing up wasn't the easiest. And my mother was addicted to drugs for quite some time. Bad experiences shaped me and defined me. Being homeless for years is a big, big issue. It was just mostly B&Bs, hostel to hostel, parks, anything at all. Yeah, it was. It was hard. It was hard. Writing for me was an escape for me, because if I didn't have writing, I probably wouldn't be here today, and that's just being true. I want other people to hear the song, and maybe I could be a voice for people who are afraid to speak up. My only advice to anybody out there is don't try and be someone you're not. Be yourself and just talk to people. It works.
Every day that I'm okay, hope the smile on my face doesn't show pain. It doesn't show pain. This is for the ones who were brave, the ones who gave up but you chose to stay. I'm done with feeling fed up, man, I tried to keep your head up. In my darkest times as my depression developed, and then I wanted to die, I wanted to escape. Wipe the tears from my face and I'll just run away. Embedded in my mind when my fears run deep, I might be strong, I got memories of being weak. I say that it's nothing and it doesn't mean a lot. I say I'm okay when you know I'm clearly not. I'm giving you a warning, I'm sick of the performing. I cry at night, man, just a smile in the morning. Depressed, sad, lonely and confused, angry and I'm mad, but I must have all bruised. That's what my depression is, terrified to always live. Every time I break down, they're trying to build another bridge. Tell myself that I'm okay, but the smile on my face doesn't show pain. It doesn't show pain. Hey, I tell myself every day that I'm okay, but the smile on my face doesn't show pain. It doesn't show pain. You're young and you shouldn't be confused. You hate the fact is that you're always in this mood. Please, dude, someone needs you. And if you open your eyes, let them see you. But now you're putting in the effort, but you should have known better. Smile on my face ain't nothing but pressure. You won't be here forever. But what you gotta remember is what you gotta remember is be strong. Don't be weak. Stand up. Find your feet. Be that person that you wanna be. The person that you wanna see. Remember this, man. The person I'm talking about, that is me. I tell myself that I'm okay, but the smile on my face doesn't show pain. It doesn't show pain. Hey, I tell myself every day that I'm okay, but the smile on my face doesn't show pain. It doesn't show pain. It never shows pain. Thank you.
This one hit me. I'm a mother of a kid with depression. It's a brutal thing for anybody to have to go through, especially a child who thinks that they're alone.
I wouldn't be here today if it wasn't for that song, myself.
I appreciate that.
Thank you.
Denise.
Do you know what? I've said before, I struggle normally with rap music because I can't understand the lyrics, but I understood every single word of your performance. Everything just got me right here. I absolutely loved it.
Thank you.
Louis.
I just wasn't expecting that. It was quite incredible. You've definitely got something special.
Thank you, Louis.
You're very brave and you're very honest.
Jason.
Yeah, you're representing a lot of kids and young people up there, so, I mean, I loved it. I thought you were brilliant. You're a brave, beautiful person. Well
and
done.
And you're hot. Is he not hot, ladies? I mean, come on! Let's vote. Louis.
100% yes. You deserve it.
Denise. Yes. Jason.
Yes!
I think you know you got a yes from me, darling.
Unconditional.
Thank you guys so much.
Unconditionally, I will love you.
Oh, don't be nervous.
Just got to take a deep breath.
Yeah, I know.
It's your one chance to shine.
Yeah.
All right? Good luck, mate. Judges await you.
Good luck. Good.
Hello.
How you doing, you all right?
Good, what's your name?
I'm Che Chesterman.
Okay, Che, where are you from?
I'm from Essex.
Are you? And how old are you, Che?
I'm 18 years old.
Okay, and what do? You work?
I used to stack shelves in Tesco, but I gave it up to become a singer.
Okay, why are you here?
I think I can win the X Factor.
Do you, why?
I think I offer something different.
Yeah, which is?
Well, I mean, there's not a lot of soul in the industry at the moment.
I would agree. It's coming back though, isn't it?
You don't think Sam Smith and Ed Sheeran are soulful?
Of course, but I mean, old school soul, like Stevie Wonder, Luther Vandross.
Okay, so what are you going to sing?
I'm going to sing a Sam Smith song, actually. It's called...
Is that a good idea?
I think so.
Tell me what else you got.
Who You Are, Jessie J.
Can I hear that?
Okay, of course.
Well, listen, good luck.
I stare at my reflection in the mirror. Why am I doing this? To myself, losing my mind on a tiny error. I nearly left the real me on the shelf, and no, 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 no.
Shay, you know, the end was really surprising because at the beginning, I wasn't quite sure. And then when you start hitting those notes, I was like, wow, I don't know how you do that or where that comes from. You deserve to own this moment. And those notes are ridiculous. I can't believe you can reach that register.
Thank you.
Rita.
Your falsetto is out of control, my friend. I mean, you have a great control in your voice. You really surprised me. I didn't know what to expect. You walked out here and honestly, never judge a book by its cover. That is an amazing audition.
Thank you, thank you.
And with Rita, I mean, it was a complete surprise. And I mean, at the start, I was like, okay, this is good. And then it got better, and I was like, oh, this is quite good. And then at the end, it was like nothing that we've heard. It was great.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
I mean, Shay, look, you are one of those rare little finds which we are lucky enough to get this year on X Factor. I think your voice is beautiful.
Thank you.
Stunning.
Thank you.
We're going to vote now. Nick.
I mean, Wembley, what do we think? Just to clarify, they said yes. That's a yes.
Rita.
You have a gorgeous smile and you have everything to smile about. It's a yes from me.
Cheryl.
I can tell by the smile on your face that the reaction you got that you weren't even expecting it. And you should know you are incredibly talented with your vocals. It's a yes from me.
Che. You've got four huge yeses. Congratulations.
Thank you.
I like him.
You must be delighted.
Oh, that was brilliant. That was absolutely brilliant. One of the best times of my life.
Enjoy that moment and we'll see you at Bootcamp, yeah?
Can't wait.
Well done, Chad.
Thank you.
Take care, man.
That was brilliant. That was a moment.
That was a new day for judging that, wasn't it?
Oh my God, so cute. You're
joking, it's my mum. You're joking. You got it
in. Who have we got here? Hello.
Callie. Savannah.
And are you sisters? Yeah. And who have you brought with you today?
Nanny.
So is she your mummy's mummy or your daddy's mummy?
Daddy's mummy.
Daddy's mummy. Okay, brilliant. And can I ask Savannah, how old are you?
3.
Amazing. And Callie, how old are you?
4.
Oh.
Cute.
What are we here for?
To surprise Dad.
What's going on?
Well, Nick doesn't know anything about it. And we're surprising him because we want him to come and sing, because he sings a lovely song for the girls. Oh. Come along, Nick.
I've just seen him.
Unbelievable. Come on, Nick.
Oh my goodness me.
Oh wow.
You just thought you were having a lovely day out.
I did. We had a whole day planned.
Well, that's changed.
Yeah, this is complete shock to me.
He said he'd never do it, so we had to do it for him.
Why did you say you'd never do it?
I think over the years, I've lost a lot of confidence in my singing. So, I tend to do it at home, in the shower. You know?
Well, I'll tell you what.
Gosh.
Nick, I'll tell you what. Why don't you go off, grab a glass of water, and then come back on? Would that be a good idea?
Thank you.
Nick, literally thought you'd run away.
I noticed you've got your words down there, which is totally fine. Do whatever it takes to get through it.
It's a song that I felt quite attached to, so I sing it quite a lot around the house. So hopefully I'll keep the nerves and the crying away whilst I'm singing.
Bless you. Yeah. Well, we are all rooting for you, aren't we?
Thank you.
I'm fine. It was so sweet. You got a nice voice.
You have such a beautiful voice. It's just, it was a really, really lovely surprise. What did you think, David?
Well, it was just so moving from start to finish, and you know, just. It just looked like you were going to burst into tears every word, actually, but yeah, I felt there was not a dry eye in the house, and that really hit me emotionally more than anything else today.
Well, it was absolutely gorgeous. Me and Alicia are in bits.
We have to vote. I'm going to say yes.
It's a yes from me.
It's a yes from me.
Well, I think you've got 4,004 yeses.
I get to love you.
My name is Madonna DeSena, and I'm 32 years old, and I'm a singer.
Single mum Madonna left her home in the Philippines 18 months ago to find work in the UK as a club singer, leaving her two children in the care of their grandparents, who receive money from her every month.
One of the hardest questions they would ask me is when I'm coming home. If I do well in this competition, it would be life-changing, not for me, just for me, but for my kids. And it's a chance for us to be together.
Off you go. Yeah.
Hello. What's your name?
Madonna DeSena.
Okay, and where are you from?
I'm from the Philippines.
So what does this mean to you to be performing on Britain's Got Talent?
Well, for me, it's a chance for me to get more work. So more work, more opportunity for me to save for my kids.
Don't worry, take your time, don't worry.
Take a deep breath.
I'll just run first.
You all charm, are you there?
Thank you.
Start when you're ready.
And now I'm singing for my girls, for their future.
If I should.
Amanda.
I know you were singing that song for your babies, weren't you? Sorry. And I don't think you need to worry, because I think that you're going to go such a long way in this show, and I think you're going to have all the money in the world, and you're going to get them on a plane, and they're going to be with you, because you, lady, have got talent.
I'm nearly gone here.
Simon.
It's always the unexpected I like on the show.
It's great.
I wasn't expecting anything like that, to be honest with you. But let me just, first of all, offer a slight reality check for a moment, OK? You've picked up some bad habits, I think, perhaps some singing in clubs and bars or something. But, you know, if you've got a talent, you've got a talent. As a performance, taking everything into account, I absolutely loved it.
Well, I just I have nothing to say other than that was absolutely brilliant. So, we come to the all-important vote. I'm going to say yes. Amanda.
Yes, obviously.
Simon, yes or no?
No. I'm not going to disappoint you. It's a yes.
Congratulations.
I thought that was fantastic. Brilliant.
What a great end to the day. Madonna's dreams are coming true, and over 6,000 miles away, two very special girls are waiting to hear the news.
Nanai, this is Nanai. I got through the contest.
I love you, Nanai.
I love you, I miss you. Bye.
Bye.
Had a stunning voice, doing a very hard song. I think she's going to go a long way in this competition.
For that one act, it was worth coming up here.
I'll try my best.
I know you will. Good luck, babes.
Here we go, the final act for this session, London.
You want to do it?
Yeah.
It's all yours. Go for it. Have fun.
Hello.
Hello.
What's your name?
My name's Kathleen Jenkins.
Hello, Kathleen. And where are you from?
I'm from Newport in South Wales.
And what do you do for a living?
I'm a cleaner in a builder's merchant.
OK. And have you brought anyone with you today?
I've brought my husband and my father. they're over there.
Brilliant. Is this the biggest audience that you've ever performed in front of?
Most definitely, yeah.
Do you feel a bit nervous?
I'm nervous, I am.
I live in a place called Newport in South Wales. The area's getting nicer, but there's not much you can do there, really. I live with my mum, my dad and my husband. It's OK living with my parents. I'd like us to get our own place, but at the moment we don't really have the funds for that. I do like my job because it pays the bills, but I daydream about being on stage.
Kathleen started singing, she was about 2 years of age, when we was pushing around in the pram. And I well up every time I hear her sing. The ears on the back of my neck stand on end, and she makes me feel like I could fly.
I'm nervous about auditioning today. I've done the odd competitions, I've done singing in a holiday park, but nothing compares to a day like this.
I've told her she's gonna have a name in lights. I can say, that's my girl. That's her, she's done it. If I could spend every penny I had to get her where she wants to go, I'd do it. And okay, I haven't got much, but she could have it all.
Best of luck, Kathleen.
Thank you very much.
World holds less.
Emotional right from the start, and you really sang it with all your heart and soul. You've got this God-given talent, and the world needs to hear it.
Thank you.
Kathleen, I am so happy for you. I know you said you were nervous, but I think all of that added to your charm, and there's something about your story and you that I want to get to know more.
Becoming rarer and rarer to find people who are genuine and who sing with heart. So thank you for auditioning for Britain's Got Talent, because you are what this show is all about.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Kathleen, I've been waiting for you all day. Someone who's just got it.
Thank you.
I love everything about you. I love the tone of your voice. I love the way you controlled the song.
Thank you. That means so much. Thank you very much.
I think you're really, really special, Kathleen.
Thank you.
I love you, Kathleen. It's a yes.
Thank you. It's a yes from me.
It's a yes from me.
Easiest yes I've given today. Four yeses.
She's amazing!
Well done.
You've done absolutely amazing.
Thank you.
I love this girl. Great. Love her, love her, love her.
I can't believe we've got four yeses.
You were brilliant, Kathleen. We told you you'd do it.
It was the best day of my life. Oh, my God, look at her shoes!
Hello.
Good evening, everybody. Been a long day.
Tell us who you are.
I'm Evelyn Williams. Okay. I live in Tower.
How old are you?
I'll be 82 on the 29th of May.
Thank you for being a friend.
Hello, welcome to Ireland's Got Talent.
Thank you. I'm here today with my granddaughter, Evelyn, and my best friend, Sue. I got married in 1961, and I had two children, a boy and a girl, and now I have six grandchildren and six great-grandchildren. I love the bones of them, of course I do. I love the bones of them. And they love Nana Chips. I forgot to tell you that today. They love Nana Chips, and they love my cabbage. My cabbage. I don't know what way my daughter must cook the stuff. I think I'm telling you all too much.
Like, my daughters have to be 9 years in Saudi Arabia.
Wow.
And my daughters have to ring me now.
Wow, to wish you good luck.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
Yeah. I know it's hard, isn't it?
Yeah. I missed them.
Of course you do, yeah.
Oh, God, my husband. I miss him like a limb. 7 years nearly now. He was a good man, you know. He was very good. He used to love to hear me sing. He was full of loving. He loved the kids. Yeah, I used to sing to them all. But so long as I do the best I can when I sing, I'll be happy. If I'm able to do it, that I'm satisfied that I've done it all right, that's okay. It's going to be a miracle. And I haven't been to Lourdes in a long time.
And Evelyn, why are you here today?
Well, I love singing. I've sung all my life.
Do you have a family? Are you married?
Oh, well married, Lou.
Yeah,
I have 6 grandchildren and I have 6 great-grandchildren.
Oh. Wow.
And my first grandchild sings as well. She was instrumental in doing this. I was singing. Am I born yet?
No, not at all.
She needs her own show.
What are you going to sing?
Send in the Clowns. Oh, it's my favourite song.
Sondheim.
Yeah. I'm living the life now tonight. Thank you. Isn't it rich? Are we a pair? Me here at last on the ground, you in midair. Send in the clowns. Isn't it bliss? Don't you approve? One who keeps tearing around, one who can't move. And where are the clowns? Send in the clowns. Just when I stopped opening doors, finally knowing the one that I wanted was yours, and making my entrance again with my usual. I'm sure of my lines. No one is there. So don't you love farce? My fault, I fear. I thought that you'd want what I want. I'm sorry, my dear. And so send in. There ought to be clowns. Well, maybe next year. Isn't it bliss? And isn't it queer? I'm losing my timing this late in my career. So send in the clowns. You know, there ought to be clowns. Don't bother there.
Here.
Congratulations. That means you go through to the semi-final.
My husband would be very proud to be here tonight. Yeah. And I want to thank every one of you, every single one of you. This is my beautiful Evelyn. Oh my God. And she's a beautiful singer. I hope I deserved it.
You do.
Michelle. I don't mean to point out the obvious, but why did you press the golden buzzer?
There is such life in this woman. She stood up here and commanded a stage better than anybody we've yet seen on this show. She's a storyteller.
Oh my God.
I'm not lucky enough to have my mother here with me on this journey. And then she stood here and she sang one of the most incredible Stephen Sondheim songs ever written, only meant to be sung by a woman this age who has lived a life.
Yeah.
And she sang it with love, and that just
Thank you, Michelle.
Judges, what are your comments?
You were incredible.
My mom and dad would be very proud of me.
Do you know who's proud of you now?
Who?
The whole of Ireland. That's who loves you.
Oh, my God.
You're great.
I hate going home now.
Angelis, you're 82 years young. You sang beautifully. And I honestly, you moved me to tears because I just love everything about you. You're a lovely, lovely lady. And I'm so pleased Michelle pressed the golden buzzer for you.
I didn't even know what that was about, like, you know. I thought they're going to kill me in a minute. They're backing me here with it.
She'll be signing autographs later.
I felt I could have sung better.
Ah, come on.
On my night. On my night.
You got the golden buzzer.
I know I got the buzzer. I am buzzed.
There was no other person that I would ever do that for. Do you know what? That was the right thing to do. She was amazing.
Don't you think?
She's 82.
Wait till she comes back. And she talks and talks and talks and talks.
And then another thing. And then the buzzer and another thing.
Where are you from?
I'm from Sheffield.
And have you brought somebody with you?
I have, yes.
Who have you brought?
I've brought some friends and my dad and, yeah, my family.
Okay, fantastic. What do you do for a living?
I've been busking for 10 years now.
Just in the street of Sheffield? Yeah. In the streets of Sheffield. Okay. And what's the response normally?
Sometimes you're singing to people that aren't listening.
So is this the biggest audience you've ever sang in front of?
Yeah. It's incredible. Hello.
Are you nervous?
Very.
Yeah, you look it, yeah. Okay. Well, good luck.
Thank you.
Vedeva mare luce cara ed era forte ventata.
Wow, wow!
Sulla cataratta, tremando due fortissimo il vento. Una mia braccia ragazza, dopo che hai fatto pianto, poi si scrisce la voce e ricomincia il canto.
against myself when demons in my head get loose. I will put you back together. I won't let you down.
Well, that was extraordinary.
Thank you.
I mean, seriously, you're so shy and quiet, and then that happens.
Thank you. Thank you.
Your passion and obviously your voice and just you, I thought, made it incredible. It was like one of those movies. This wasn't supposed to happen, and it was brilliant.
Thank you.
Amazing.
That means a lot. Thank you.
Wow, wow, wow. I mean, the hairs on my arms stood up literally as soon as you started. Right. It just felt romantic and powerful and meaningful and all the feels. Yeah, that was good.
Thank you. Thank you.
I mean, I feel for you because you're so talented. You're such an extraordinary voice. I hope that, you know, going forward, that you feel more appreciated. Because, you know, these people were on their feet for you.
Yes, they were.
I really hope that that reaction has done something for your confidence, because you are better than standing on a pavement.
Thank you very much, Amanda. Thank you.
Yes, you need to start believing in yourself, Maxwell, because after that, you are heading for the big time. Sometimes when someone sings like that, you can almost feel yourself sort of levitating,
yes,
aren't you? And that's happened so infrequently, and you gave us that feeling today. So it's a pleasure to give you your first yes!
Thank you very much. Thank you.
It's
Thank
an you. Easy yes from me.
Thank you, Alicia.
Absolutely yes from me.
Thank you, Amanda.
I'm working out how many people are in here. I'd say about 4,000. So that means you've got just about 4,000 yeses.
Good evening.
How are you?
I'm terrified, excited, delighted, all the emotions.
Oh, sounds about right. What's your name?
My name's Ronan Busfield.
And what's your day job?
I work for a supermarket. It begins with T and ends in Esco.
Would you like to continue working in Tesco?
I would like to continue working there if things didn't work out here. Hopefully.
Well, good luck.
Thank you.
He looks terrified.
The most beautiful sound I ever heard. Maria, 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 Maria. The beautiful sounds of the world in a single word. Maria, 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 Maria. I just met a girl named Maria, and suddenly that name will never be the same to me. Maria, I just kissed a girl named Maria, and suddenly I found how wonderful a sound can be. Maria,
listen to that.
Sing loud, there's music playing.
How are you doing?
Do you want to introduce yourself?
My name's Ricky. I'm from Southwest London.
Yeah.
And I have my beautiful family watching me. I've got my daughter. We just had a baby. She's 6 months. Hence why I've got quite a hoarse voice, because I'm no sleep, so.
What's her name?
Baby Star. And Heavenly is the older one. She's 10.
Heavenly and Star. What are you going to sing for us today?
I'm going to sing Sam Cooke, Change Is Gonna Come.
Okay, big song.
What does that song mean to you?
I was actually, without going into it too much, I was homeless for 8 years. So I really needed a change to come. Mm-hmm. My name's Ricky, I'm 36 years old, and I'm from Southwest London. Life before I met my partner wasn't great. I was homeless for about 8 years. Grew up, was on my own from sort of like 16. Now I've met my Alicia. We just hit it off. We just had this great chemistry. She's given me two beautiful children, and she's given me my smile back. And they have just changed my life to the point that I didn't think I ever saw anything this beautiful and this amazing. And now this could be an opportunity where something could actually be good in our lives and we can actually have something.
So have you tried out for anything like this before?
I haven't.
Okay. Good luck.
Ricky, I know you might have a problem with your throat at the moment. Nobody else in this audience knew that other than you, lad. That was an unbelievable audition.
Not only are you rocking the man bun, but you're rocking Wembley Arena right now.
Wow.
Ricky, your voice is so strong and your personality is so strong, and I'd like to see so much more from you, so.
Thank you, guys. Thank you so much.
The point when it almost fell apart is the point where I really, really, really liked you, because you picked yourself up. This is why we make the show, genuinely, to find people like you.
I'm gonna kick this off. It's a yes from me!
Yes from me.
I think you've just changed your life today. I really do.
Thank you.
And obviously it's a yes.
You got four yeses.
How you doing?
And what's your name, please?
My name is Jason.
And where are you from?
I'm from East London.
Cool. How old are you, Jason?
I'm 25 years old.
Okay, tell me what the song you've chosen to sing today is and why.
The song is a song I wrote called Bullet in My Heart, and it was the only song I wrote throughout the whole year in 2015.
And why X Factor this year, please?
I suddenly lost my mum in 2015. I've always been terrified to do this show, but I was going through Texas, and I remember my mum always telling me, you need to do the X Factor, you need to do the X Factor. And I always said no, we had a couple arguments about it. And reading that text, I was just like, you know what, I want to finally tick off something she's told me to do. And I just want to inspire someone else, and I hope I inspire people now.
What was your mother's name?
Victoria.
Victoria.
Yeah.
Okay, let's do this for Victoria.
Well done, bro. Thanks, guys. Thank you. voice off. Your voice, your soul, your passion, incredible. I feel you so much.
Thank you.
J-Saul, in 2014, I lost my father very unexpectedly, and I'll never forget how the world swallowed me up on that day when I found out. And I just want to thank you, because that was a beautiful song and a powerful song. And I know your mom would be really proud of you. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
That is the power of music, is that you can write such a beautiful song that has touched us all on this panel. It was absolutely brilliant. It was moving. You're a legend for what you've just done.
Thank you.
Wow, J-Saul. I understand how difficult that would have been to perform that, but you did. And it was an amazing audition. You have an amazing voice. This is something we're all going to remember. I just have to kick this off with the first yes.
Thank you so much for sharing that with us. It's a yes.
That was an amazing song, and it's a yes from me.
Thank you.
It's a yes from me.
Thank you so much.
I talk to my mum every day, my dad, you the same? Literally.
Literally.
Learn that, right? Every decision you want to make, you always talk to them.
Thank you so much.
You've got something special. I'm glad that you came on the show.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
See you later. Go, Brianna!
Whenever you're ready.
Couldn't have been going any better. That's all I can say. It was perfect.
It's okay. Do you want to take a moment? You can take a minute. It's okay. It's all right. You can take a minute. It's okay. We've got all the time in the world, all right? It's okay.
Hey, darling.
I was messing up. No, you didn't.
You didn't mess this up at all.
You didn't mess it. You're doing an amazing job.
Everybody, okay? Everybody out there absolutely adores you.
It was wonderful. It was beautiful. We would love to hear it again if you feel up to it.
Like to?
Yeah?
You know, nerves are a good thing sometimes, you know. They show how much you care. We're all on your side. We're your friends, okay?
Let's go.
You with the sad eyes, don't be discouraged, though I realize it's hard to take.
Back on that horse, it was incredible.
Yes.
And let's hear it for Brianna one more time.
I'm so proud of you.
You don't understand.
Oh my goodness, congratulations.
Oh, well, I was just so moved. Not just by your performance, but by you too, you know, how brave you were. And we've all been there, you know, it's 16 years old. That's incredible just to come on that stage and have the courage to stand there. And then it all got overwhelming, and not because it wasn't going well, because it was actually going brilliantly, but you got emotional. It makes you human. It makes us love you even more. And it was a beautiful moment, and you deserve that more than anybody. So well done,
Brianna.
Thank
you. Thank you.
You're a star.
Congratulations. Can't wait to see you in the semi-final.
She deserved it for her courage.
100%.
Oh, she was adorable though, wasn't she?
You have a guaranteed spot to the semi-finals. We are going to see you perform again.
Really cool. That was a great
one.
Well done.
Yeah, especially with some Indigenous lyrics as well. I think that really makes it really, really special, really memorable, and it really gives it extra weight, doesn't it?
Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
Who are you?
We're the Neils.
Are you related?
Yes, I'm Laurie, and these are my three sons.
How old are you all?
So I'm 24, I'm 26, and I'm 28.
And Dad?
60 this year.
Do you have jobs?
I work in marketing. I work in a bank.
I'm a lawyer. Sorry.
So what made you form this group?
10 years ago, our dad had a heart attack. And that made him realise it needed to change the way he lives his life, pursue the thing that he loves, and that's singing. And the three of us are here because we realise the reason he had that heart attack was because he'd ran himself into the ground trying to provide for us. So you'd have thought when he asked us to come on Britain's Got Talent, try and help him achieve his dream of being a singer, we'd have said yes. But it took him 3 years of pestering. But we're here now. When we heard that our dad was ill, everything goes through your head.
He's the person that we all look up to. He's the head of the family. To have your dad potentially taken away, it was one of the worst times in our lives.
And it really was a wake-up call. It made me realise there's more to life than just working.
I'm old enough to know that this is the last chance I'm ever going to get.
No pressure.
No pressure. No pressure.
Last chance I'm ever going to get.
The boys have always liked singing, and I've always enjoyed a bit of karaoke and that sort of thing.
We'd get together at family events and Christmas time. We'd all had a few drinks, and we'd like to sing a few songs together.
I want to realise a dream of singing with the boys, and they decided they'd do it, and that's why we're here today.
When we sing together, it is a magical moment. I just think we've found something that you only find in times of adversity.
what started off as our dad's dream is quickly kind of becoming a dream that we all share.
First public performance today.
Wow!
How have the private performances gone?
Our mum and nan say we're brilliant. So.
Just to be on the stage with my three sons, they know it means a lot to me, and it does. I couldn't be more proud.
Fantastic. And where's the mama?
Somewhere in the audience.
There she is.
And our nan, who's it's her 85th birthday today.
Happy birthday, nan! Okay, well, when you're ready, good luck.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
You know what? I absolutely love that audition. Just to see you supporting each other and this fantastic bond, it was just amazing.
Thank you. Oh, it's really, really touching, actually. I cannot think of a better way to perform them with your family and the people that you love. You guys are fantastic.
Thank you. Thank you, Chris.
Thank you.
You get something very special with Family Band, I think, because you just get a beautiful blend of voices and just lovely to see the four of you enjoying being on stage together. It was fantastic.
You know that things happen in life to make you live life better. It was touching. It really, really was.
Thank you so much.
Let's take a vote. David.
I'm going to say yes.
Thank you. Thank you.
Alicia.
It's a yes from me, guys.
It's a yes from me.
Four very big fat yeses.
You make me scared. What's your name?
Jana. My name is Janet Devlin. I'm 16 and I'm from Tyrone in Northern Ireland.
How are you feeling about this?
Nervous.
I bet you are. I can tell you are.
I'm from a small village called Gorchin. My house is quite literally in the middle of nowhere. It's pretty bleak. Because of where I live, I do spend a lot of time by myself in my room, like, reading, writing and singing.
the reason why I haven't really been out singing is probably the lack of confidence, and it's a lot easier to sing in the house than it is to go out in front of an audience.
I've been writing songs and poetry since I was about 7 years old. It just gives you an easy escape to like get your thoughts out of your head so they stop bugging you.
All right, sweetheart, good luck, go on.
This competition is such a huge contrast to anything I've ever done before. The fact that I've been able to fly over here and do this audition is huge. It could be life-changing potentially, and I hope it is. I'm so nervous that, I can't even put into words how nervous I am.
Side stage, I don't think I'm going to be able to breathe.
3, 2, 1, on you go.
How are you doing?
I'm good, yeah.
Yeah. What's your name?
My name's Janet Devlin.
Janet. How old are you, Janet?
I'm 16.
16. Wow. Janet, where are you from?
I'm from Northern Ireland.
Northern Ireland. Where about?
A place called Tyrone. Tyrone. It's a pretty small town. I don't even live in the town. I live in the blatant countryside,
okay,
so
okay.
There's not that much you can do.
Okay, is this a big dream for you, being on The X Factor?
It feels like a dream. It feels like I haven't even woken up yet, even just being right here and there's so many people, it's like, whoa.
Okay, and what are you going to sing for us today?
Your song by Elton John.
Okay, wow. Good luck, Janet.
Good luck, everyone.
It's a little bit funny, this feeling inside. I'm not one of those who can easily hide. I don't have much money, but boy, if I did, buy a big house where we both could live. And you can tell everybody this is your song. It may be quite simple, but and now that it's done, I hope you don't mind. I hope you don't mind. Then again, no. Or a girl makes potions in a traveling show. I know it's not much, but it's the best I can do. My gift is my song, and this one's for you. And you can tell everybody this is your song.
Goodness, I am completely just in a trance by your voice. It is so beautiful.
You could have heard a pin drop in here. It was so silent because you came in here, you were nervous, and she's like, hello. It makes me love you even more. You are such a star. What a wonderful audition. Yes.
Janet, I love the fact that you're so shy, so endearing. That is a recording vocal.
Janet, I don't think you have any idea how good you are, and that's what I like most about you. You're only 16, and you've got this very distinctive voice, and you're so likeable. And you're from Ireland.
Oh, yeah. Thanks.
Janet, all the time when we're looking for these artists, we're trying to find people who will eventually sell records, sell albums around the world, not just in the UK, but everywhere. And you are one of those people. It was such a fantastic audition. And I think we're going to vote now. Louis.
Janet Devlin. Massive yes.
Janet, I was absolutely mesmerised by you today. It's a yes from me.
Janet, congratulations once again, Mama. You blew us away. Absolutely yes.
Janet Devlin from Northern Ireland. Four yeses. Congratulations.
It'll be really interesting to watch her develop. And yeah. Just, she's beautiful.
Beautiful.
Oh, my God, I wanted to cry so much. Well done.
I'm so surprised you didn't cry. I'm so
surprised. How do you feel now?
Gobsmacked.
Hello.
Hello to you.
Hello to you.
Did you go into my wardrobe? Can you please tell us what your name is?
I am Sean Miley Moore.
Where are you from?
Australia. Yeah, so my dad's from Britain originally, and all my cousins and my family's here, so yeah. I haven't seen them in like 10 years. I've just moved here as of 2 weeks ago. So
hold on, so you moved from Australia to do UK X Factor?
Yes.
My name is Sean Miley Moore. I'm 24 years old, and I've moved here from Australia. I have a UK passport, so I was like, book a one-way ticket. And I'm living in London. Hola. It's cool to see all my family again. It's like double trouble for the biggest show in the world and to see my home. It's very important to express yourself through fashion, through music, through, I don't know, just screaming on the top of your lungs. If it makes you feel happy and great, then do it. Living in Australia, I kind of get a mixture of reactions. You know, walking down the street, people looking at you like, what the hell is that? In London, and people are just like, yeah, work it. And I'm like, thank you, you know, because I think it's more accepting. So my dream is Sean Miley Moore on Madison Square Garden. Today means a lot. Music has allowed me kind of be me. I'm reaching for the stars, and that's why I'm gonna give you everything.
What are you gonna sing for us?
The Show Must Go On by Fabulous Freddy.
Is there a reason why you chose this song?
Yeah, taking a chance and moving across the world. And it's scary. I mean, London's amazing, but it's scary. But yeah.
You know what? Good luck.
Thank you.
Empty spaces. What are we living for? Abandoned places. I guess we know the score. On and on. Does anybody know what we are living for? show must go on. The show.
Didn't want to, and I couldn't take my eyes off her throughout your whole song. You were fearless, sharp, sassy. You were just giving us everything. You were amazing.
That was hands down the best thing that I've seen all day. I loved it. I thought it was 100% you, and it was addictive. You're the person that everyone's going to talk about tonight.
Thank you so much.
Let's go to Simon.
Sean, can I just first of all say that welcome back to the UK. I always, always wanted to find an artist on this show that you can't compare with anybody else, who's got originality, and most importantly, you've got to remember somebody. And I'm going to remember this audition for a very, very long time. I think you're great.
So much passion and so much determination and so much individuality. There is nothing I can say to you apart from I'm so happy that you came on the show. Should we come to a vote, gang?
Yeah. Nick, it's a yes from me, Sean.
Thank you so much.
Yes, biggest yes of the day.
It's a yes from me.
Rita.
Sean, 3,804 yeses.
Thank you.
This is why I did this show. I'm just so relieved that there's so much passion left in people.
My name is Jackie, I'm 53 years old, originally from Wales. Now I live on a farm in Oxfordshire. I've got my daughters, Kelly and Freddie, here with me, and my stepdaughter, Vicky. I want my daughter to marry you.
I'm right here.
I'm fine, darling. And she's single. She's studying at King's.
Oh,
but I'm looking forward to seeing Robbie and singing for him. I reckon he'd be down to earth. What do you reckon he'd say there, like? Robbie is not just an entertainer, he's an icon. He's the kind of guy I'd like in my family. I know it's impossible, but that's how I feel.
Hello, darling.
Hello.
How are you?
Nervous.
Nervous. Do you want to introduce yourself to us and everyone else?
My name is Jackie. I'm 53 years old. I live on a farm in Oxfordshire. We have chickens, ducks, horses, and Dave, my peacock. And he's got a friend called Chaz. It's Chaz and Dave. Chaz is a white peacock. What they tend to do is they like to attack their own reflection.
Do you know what? That's so funny, because I was just thinking, this is my peacock, Robbie. And he loves his reflection.
Are you married?
Yes, Bobby. And he's at home minding all the animals today.
Oh, bless Bobby. Are you Jackie or Jacqueline?
I don't mind. You can call me anything you like. You're Robbie Williams.
Oh, bless you, Bobby. What are you going to sing for us today?
A Cilla Black song, You're My World.
Great.
And I don't know if madam, but she looks so nervous right now.
You're my world, you're every breath I take. You're my world, you're every move I make.
Hey, good start.
Dreams reach for the sun above. So your arms reach out to me for love. With your hand resting in mine, I feel a power so divine. You're my world, you're my light and air. You're my world, you're every breath I breathe. If our love ceases to be, then it's the end of my love, end of my world, end of my world for me.
Remind me of everything that's great about my home.
Yeah?
You just transport me to sort of safety and kindness. There's something really special about you.
Thank you.
I just fell in love with you, Jacqueline. All I could think about was how proud Bobby would be of you and your peacocks at the farm. And I was just falling in love with that moment for you and falling in love with you and falling in love with my husband. And I just want to say I think you're incredible.
For me, you know, it's stories like this. This is exactly what the show should be about. It's someone at your age standing up there and having a real moment like that.
Yeah, Jack, I'm going to be honest with you. As you walked out, I'm kind of thinking to myself, maybe you've walked onto the wrong show by mistake. And I'm thinking, this isn't going to be great. And then you were. I mean, there was no other way of putting it. And actually, You're a little tiger, aren't you?
Yes.
Well, that's what it's all about. That's why we will never, ever put an age barrier.
I don't care if I die tomorrow, honestly. This was just amazing.
OK, let me kick this off. I'm going to say no.
What?
I'm kidding. It's a yes.
Great audition, well done. It's a yes from me.
Can I have a cuddle later?
Oh, please, yes.
OK, I love you, yeah. Big yeah from me.
You just went through. It's a yes from me.
Well done, Jacqueline.
Hello.
Hello.
What's your name?
My name is Evangel Omari Bisson.
What is your talent?
I can sing and I can play piano.
Are you nervous?
Very, actually.
Yeah?
But really, all I need to do is just do what I have to do and be done with it.
Take a deep breath. Ready? In. And let it out. So now, the stage is yours. Show us your gift.
Thank you.
Do I feel to how I feel? I wonder, wouldn't it be nice to live inside a world that isn't black and white? I wonder what it's like to be my friends. Hope that they don't think I forget about them. I wonder. I wonder.
I want to say something. Everybody in the room thinks you're great, but you were really nervous, right?
Right.
Yes. I want you to sing it one more time because I want it to sound perfect and you have perfection.
So from start to finish?
Yep.
Yes.
All right.
Do I feel to how I feel? I wonder why I'm so afraid of saying something wrong. I never said I was a saint. I wonder why crying to my hands. I'm conditioned to feel like it makes me less of a man. And I wonder if someday you'll be by my side. Tell me that the world will end up alright. I wonder. I wonder. Saw my mind and dream me that you feel it. You wonder what it is like to be loved by you. Yeah. I wonder what it's like. I wonder what it's like to be loved by me. Before I close my eyes, the only thing that saw my mind and dream me that you.
I have a surprise for you for a second. Are you a big Shawn Mendes fan?
Yes.
Because Shawn thought your performance was amazing.
What?
Yeah.
No!
So, Shawn, this young boy just sang your song and absolutely crushed it.
I'm so happy. Keep singing. I hope everything goes amazing over there for you.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you, Shawn. I'll let you know how this goes. I appreciate you.
The producers will be in touch to your lawyers. Thank you. Goodbye.
What's your name?
My name is Alison Jaya.
Do you mind me asking how old you are?
I'm 49.
Okay, and do you have a job?
I do. I work as a singer, do a lot of backing vocals on TV shows and commercials.
So you don't want to be in the background anymore?
Do you know what? I love being in the background. I love what I do, and I'm really grateful for that sort of work, but I have a lot more that I want to achieve. I've worked as a studio singer from the age of 19. I've done a lot of really silly work over the years. I did a Burger King commercial, cheese strings commercial. Maybe where you're supposed to be. I was in the business for 30 years. I'm very grateful for it, but I work hard and sometimes it goes unrecognized. Your voice is never too loud. For me, nothing compares to walking out on stage to perform. But I want to be there in my own right. Gotta let it out. I've tried to get a record deal, and sometimes I think maybe there's a reason why you're a backing vocalist, but I don't want to stop dreaming, you know? That's why I'm here. But you're looking for a reason to break free. And I want to show my kids that you shouldn't be scared. You should chase it, no matter whether you're 7, 18, or 49. It's just time for me to just stick my neck on the chopping block and give it a go.
This is it. This is your moment. Good luck.
You know what? That was probably one of the best vocals we've ever had on the show. Because it was like all the years of doing these commercials, being behind the scenes, getting frustrated, and this was your one shot, and my God, you took it.
David?
We always say on the show, you know, you've got 2 minutes to change your life, and in that 2 minutes, we saw a star being born tonight.
That was mighty, it was magnificent, it was powerful.
You've made some hugely brave decisions in your life, and this was one of them, coming on this stage, and it's paid off. That was an incredible, incredible audition, so well done. We're going to take a vote. David?
The biggest yes I've ever given.
Alison, 3,204 yeses.
Wow! Hi. What is your name?
My name is Bryn Cummings, and I'm a ventriloquist.
Ah. How old are you?
I'm 12.
Where are you from?
We're from Paw Paw, Michigan.
How did you get into doing this? How did you know you could do this?
Well, it was actually, I remember seeing Darcy Lynn on AGT, and that inspired me. I literally looked at my parents as soon as I saw it, and I went, that's what I'm going to do. Aww. So.
And look at you now, right here in front of us. That's amazing. What are you going to do if you win $1 million?
I mean, it's a big thing, but probably I'd like to follow in Darcy's footsteps and start touring, so get like a tour bus, and I also really want a bearded dragon.
Oh, wow. Okay, we're ready, go ahead. Right.
All right, Penelope, it's our big moment. Are you ready for me to cue the music? I don't want to sing anymore. What? This is what we've practiced for weeks. I've been thinking about it, and it's been done. They want to see something else, something new. But we haven't practiced anything else. What's your plan? I've got it! Mentalism!
Mentalism?
Wait, what?
I don't mind, Reed. Quit playing around. Let's just sing the song. Trust me. Taking down to the judges. Is that allowed?
Yeah.
Sure.
Yeah.
I have a bad feeling about this. Oh, stop worrying. Seriously, I don't know what I'm supposed to do. It's okay, we'll use a deck of cards. Check your pocket. Wait, what? Ta-da! Heidi, yes. I'd like you to cut the deck one time. Howie, I'd like you to take the top card.
All right.
Then look away and close your eyes. Show me the card. I will send my thoughts to Drin using my brilliant mental powers. What do I do now? Just concentrate. What comes to mind? A migraine. Drin! Okay, I'm focused. I see. I think it's black. That's it. Keep thinking. It's a club. Is it the Seven of Clubs? Open your eyes. Oh my gosh! What?
That's amazing. That's crazy.
Judges, in a moment, we're going to go back on stage. That as we do. Sophia.
Hi.
Please take out any item from your purse, but keep it hidden for now.
Okay.
Simon, please run out into the audience and grab an object. Any object from anyone. Yep, in the audience. And judges, don't let us see what you picked. Do not let us see what you picked. Let's make this a little more interesting. Terry, can you bring out the blindfold? Blindfold? Terry, inspect the blindfold. Hold it up to the light. Can you see through it?
No, I can't.
Perfect. Please put it on the ring.
Okay.
Make it nice and tight. Nice and tight. Perfect. Perfect. Thank you, Terry. You can go. You can leave now. Thank you so much. You're gonna figure out what objects the judges are holding. Sophia, hold your object up into the air. Drin, clear your mind. So Drin, what do you see? I see it's a food. It has some sugar in it. It might be like a good treat. Maybe you leave it when Santa comes. Is it a cookie? Sophia, what was your object?
It's an oatmeal cookie!
Oh my gosh! Since doing so well. You're gonna try this one solo. Penelope, come on, I need your help. Fine, here's a clue. Silent object can fit inside of this room. Penelope, come on. Wait, I'm getting something. It's an accessory. You might wear it on your ankle. No, you wear it on your wrist. Is it an Apple Watch?
Yes.
Wow.
Oh my gosh! Wow! Thank you, everyone!
That's amazing.
It's so great to see you right up close, how good you're doing it. I loved it.
Thank you so much.
This is the season of mashups. The fact that you did magic or mentalism and ventriloquism at the same time, you're amazing, young
lady. Thank you so much.
Yes, yes.
I loved it too, because you really figured out like a perfect little act for yourself. You're part comedian too. I thought it was a lot of fun. Well done.
Thank you so much.
When did you realize that you have magic powers?
When I was about 9 years old, I would say.
That's cool. You are so talented, so charming. People are gonna root for you. You did something we've never seen before. And for me, you never want to see the same thing again, but not quite as good. You want to see it better or different, and that's what you did.
Thank you.
Okay, we're going to vote. Sophia.
I'm going to give you your first yes.
Second yes.
Third yes.
Four yeses!
She did it! She did it! Oh my goodness. Oh. Oh my goodness. Gwen, tell me what you're feeling right now.
This is the best moment of my life.